I guess the first question is, you have a scouting report on Northern Colorado for Sac State tonight.
I don't, but you know the way Sac State's been playing, they've figured out ways to come from behind when they're down, so they're never out of a ball game. So I don't care what the score is, stay till the end tonight because they will have a chance to come back and get it done at the Hornets' Nest. That's right, right?
The Hornets' Nest, right?
Or just the Nest?
I think everyone just calls it the Nest, yeah.
Okay, take two, start again. Stay the whole game tonight. Stay to the end because they have a chance to come back at the Nest. Let's get it done, DP. Stingers up.
So you obviously have a scouting report on the Rockets that worked pretty well for you last night. What kind of adjustments do you want to make in this day in between those two games?
Well, just like they probably feel the same. There are some areas that we didn't do a good job of. We gave up a few back doors. We didn't communicate well in our pick and roll situations, especially when we were required to switch out there on the floor. And you know, you do small things like that time after time, and not necessarily the same person all the time, but this guy doesn't once, that guy doesn't once, that guy doesn't once. Now you have three or four back doors that you gave up. You have three or four times in the pick and roll that you didn't communicate really well, and they get downhill and they get an easy look. So to try to clean those little things up so they're not cumulative on the defense end of the floor will be big for us. I thought we did a great job. I think we took 48 threes. When you go back and you watch, most of the threes were wide open or threes that we like to take. They just didn't go in at the rate that we wanted them to go in that we normally see them go in. So offensively, the way we played, I think we had 9 turnovers, something like that. We'll take it. We'll take the threes that we took. We just need to clean up a few areas defensively so that hopefully, knock on wood, they don't get comfortable to start the game and throughout the game because of the minor mistakes we're making here and there.
Mike, where are we at with Kevin? Is he better? Is he not? Do you think he'll be available tomorrow?
He's better, but he still has some issues. He's out with a non-COVID illness, but he is getting better.
Any chance he plays tomorrow?
I don't know. I'm not sure if he will or if he won't tomorrow.
And we were just talking to Keegan. Like, how has he responded to sort of your tough love, whether it be in media or in practice sessions or whatever?
Great. And that's what I like a lot about him is, if he can handle that, then the sky's the limit for him because I've gone at him pretty hard. And he doesn't get too high or too low. He stays even keeled. He looks me in the eye. He responds back to me with what he's feeling and or thinking. And for a young guy, that's remarkable. I look back in my time as an early assistant in this league and watching Popovich get after Tony Parker. Keegan may, if I could teleport Keegan back in time to be Tony Parker and then bring him back here, he'd hug me and cry on my shoulders, begging me to keep him here instead of sending him back there to be Tony Parker. So, again, Tony Parker turned out great. I think Keegan's going to be just as good because we want him. We're relying on him to start. We're relying on him to play heavy minutes. So it can't be, he's a rookie. So, no, you're in the starting lineup. You take the same shots as other guys do. You have a lot of responsibility. And so you got to get it right, not yesterday, not tomorrow, but right now.
Yesterday, Mezzi may not have had the punch he did off the bench offensively, but did you see certain things that maybe didn't translate to what most people would see on the offensive end from him?
100%. He's such a vertical, he's such a great vertical threat at the rim. And so anytime he dives, if bodies don't come, then he's getting a dunk. And so when he dives, he's just sucking the defense in. And this, we talk about spray threes, paint threes, and it doesn't always have to come from the drive and kick. It can come from somebody as athletic as Mezzi rolling in a pick and roll situation, collapsing the defense, and now we throw the skip pass to the guy on the weak side shaking up behind Mezzi. So little things like that, working behind the defense at times, causes a weak side defender to have to come in and tag him because they've seen his ability to catch and quick dunk there, his ability to offense a rebound. You've got to go put a body on him. So now somebody else like Trey or something like that may get a rebound because they're not only at times sending one body but two bodies to him. So his athleticism offensively has helped out. And then defensively, his versatility, allowing us to switch. I mean, that lineup can be pretty big at times when you're talking about having KZ, Trey, and Mezzi, or even HB for one of those two other guys on the floor with Malik and Davion. That's a long athletic lineup. And those little things, plus the ability to switch defensively, plus the ability to run the floor in transition with Mezzi's quicker than any other center he's going to play against, are all big factors in him being out on the floor and helping us have some success.
Keegan's shooting a better percentage from three this year as a pro than he did last year in college. Well, what's gone into that from your perspective?
His work ethic. I mean, he really works at it. And I don't know, maybe one or two all year, if there was a time I can say he took a quote-unquote bad off-balance three. Most of his threes, he's getting to the spot, he's getting his feet set, and he's getting ready to shoot. All the, you know, the stuff you teach little kids, oh, get there, show your hands, get your feet. He's doing it to a T. And, you know, his preparation on the offense end of the floor, in my opinion, and then our guys believing and trusting in him and putting that thing right on time, right on target, have a lot to do with him knocking that ball, that three ball down.
And with Malik sort of having kind of an up and down season, when you're coaching a guy who scores like he does, do you ever insert yourself into, you know, like do you ever feel like you need to say something or tell him to maybe switch this up, or do you just kind of let, like, what's the balance you try to find between letting a guy come out of his slump naturally versus inserting yourself into that?
All right, so there are two guys, you know, to me, Domas and Foxy are two players that have an opportunity to be great for us. And so they got a lot of freedom. You know, it's in our business, for me, a guy in my position, it's one of those things where you treat everybody the same but different. And what that means is you'll figure that out as we go along. But, you know, Foxy and Domas are different. And then my two guys offensively next would probably be Malik and Kevin. You know, I'm not a huge fan of a contested pull-up two, you know, or a guy that's going to dribble five, six, seven, eight, nine times and get a look. But I'm going to give those guys some freedom because those guys have made plays for us consistently throughout the year. And I don't want them to think that every time they do something that's out of the box, they're going to be hearing me yell at them. So they both have some freedom, which means if they're in a little bit of a slump, I'm going to give them some freedom. But I got to make sure, the one thing I'm going to make sure is, are you getting the required work in, you know, pre-practice, post-practice, or any other time? And if you are, then I believe in you enough that I know you're going to come out of your slump. So I don't say much to those guys in that situation as long as they're getting their work in. And I mean, you guys saw Malik. He was in here getting his work in. And so, you know, if he doesn't shoot it as well, we're going to stick with him as long as he's doing his part, which he is doing.
All right, thank you, guys.
All right.
Thank you all.
You going to be at the game tonight?
Yeah.
Have fun.
Yeah,
we'll go.